Hello everybody, welcome to Patiala classes. My name is Swamil Malhotra. Today I'm going to discuss a current affair issue, that is a Gorkhaland issue and its genesis. Every now and then there is a news related to the Darjeeling crisis, which is a district in the northern part of the West Bengal. And there is a news related to Gorkhaland. Gorkhaland is what? It is a proposed state in India demanded by people living in the Darjeeling Hills. Darjeeling Hill mein jo log reh rahe hain, they wanted to create a new state for themselves that will be known as a Gorkhaland. Aur ye unka ye proposed map hai, Gorkha Janmukti Morcha ne proposed kiya hai ye map, which will include Darjeeling Hill, Siliguri, Dwar region and the Tarai region. And their demand for the Gorkhaland is basically on the ethnic demand. Although they all are the Indian citizen, but still they called as a Nepalese because at some point of the time in the history, they have migrated from the Nepal and their language is also Nepali. So that is why they have to face some kind of discriminations. To understand the current crisis of the Darjeeling, we need to go through the some background of it. Before 1780s, Darjeeling was a part of the Sikkim, which was ruled by Chogyal dynasty at that time. Around 1780s, Gorkhas of the Nepal invaded the Sikkim and captured most of its part, including the Darjeeling. Usi time ke pe kya hua ke Britishers ne dekha ke Gorkhas the jo Nepal ke, they are trying to overrun the whole of this area. They wanted to capture all of this area. So in 1814, Anglo-Nepalese war broke out to prevent these Gorkhas from overrunning the whole of the northern frontier. Finally, in this war, Gorkhas were defeated and this war came to an end on 4th March 1816 through the Treaty of Sagoli, through which Nepal had to cede all those territories that the Gorkhas had annexed from the Chogyal of the Sikkim to the British East India Company. And that is how Darjeeling became the part of British India. Then come the migration issue and the tea plantation. How these Nepali speaking people came to this region of the Darjeeling. In 1829, Britishers found Darjeeling as a potential place for the tea plantation. At that time, it was inhabited by the tribals known as the Lepchas, who were the original inhabitants of this region, and the Limbus. As we all know that the tea plantation is a labor intensive crop, so Britishers floated a rumor in the Nepal that in the tea plantation money is spread everywhere. You can find gold in the core of the tea plantation. And that is how, in the search of this gold, or we can say that for the employment in the tea plantation, the migration from the Nepal has been taken place. By 1989, the Lepchas, who were the original inhabitants, who were taken the refugee in the Nepal, Sikkim and Bhutan during the wartime, returned to this region to work in the tea plantation fields. When these Nepali speaking people started work in the fields of the Darjeeling, they faced discrimination on the basis of language and their race. Let's see what was their grievance. There was a rigid segregation was maintained between the Nepali migrations in the hill and the Chota Nagpur Plateau of the plains. Chota Nagpur Plateau is this region of the West Bengal. The western part of the West Bengal is Chota Nagpur Plateau. And few Bengalis present in the hills were always been considered as a babus. Unko babus kaya jata tha, jo Bengali yahan ke hills mein rehte the. And they were perceived as an elite who worked for the Britishers and after the independence for the government of India. That is why, because this Nepalis who has faced the discrimination on the basis of race and language, they feel themselves to reduce to a second class citizen. And that is how the demand for the Gorkhaland has always found its port among the tea plantation workers. Then come to the demand for the separate state. How this demand got the momentum? In 1907, first plea was made by the Hillsman Association of the Darjeeling for the administrative setup outside of Bengal to the Minto Morley reform panel, which was rejected. When this was rejected, thereafter a numerous representation has been made every few years, first to the Britishers, then to the Free Indian Government, but every time their demand has been neglected. Even during the debates of the Constituent Assembly, the demand for the separate state was raised by Ari Bahadur Gurung, who was a member of the Constituent Assembly, again it was neglected. As the demand for the separate state was repeatedly coming, so in 1961, Government of India half-heartedly made the Nepali or recognized the Nepali language as the official language of Bengal in the hills of the West Bengal. So this was obviously not going to solve the problem at all. So what happened next? The struggle for the Matomis, their motherland, has been started. Until so far, there has been two mass-based agitation has been faced by India. First was led by the Subhash Ghi Singh, who founded the Gorkha National Front in 1980, and he started the agitation in 1986, which took the violent turn for the very first time, which led to the death of the 1200 people. Finally, in 1988, this agitation came to an end through the establishment of semi-autonomous body called the Darjeeling Gorkha Hill Council under the leadership of then Chief Minister of Jyoti Basu and the then Prime Minister of India Rajiv Gandhi, who played the crucial role to get the agreement signed, where the Gorkha National Liberation Front had agreed to drop their separate statehood demand and accepted the great autonomous for the Darjeeling Hills. So, in 1992, Government of India wanted to settle the remaining grievance related to their language. So, they recognized Nepali as the official language under the 8th schedule of the Constitution of India, and which was added through the 71st Amendment Act of 1992. Then, second stage of the agitation started under the leadership of Bimal Gurung, who founded the Gorkha Jan Mukti Morcha in 2007. And the current demand for the separate Gorkhaland has been also led by same person, Bimal Gurung. He again raised the demand for the Gorkhaland. Finally, his agitation came to an end in 2011 after the agreement was signed between the state and the central government for the formation of Gorkha Territorial Administration, which was a semi-autonomous body, and it replaced Darjeeling Gorkha Hill Council and became him as a CEO of Gorkha Territorial Administration. So he became the CEO of Gorkha Territorial Administration. Lekin uske baad kya hua? 2013 mein Telangana ka issue saamne aaya aur Telangana ko alag state banane ke liye government ne haan kar di. Finally, iske chalte isne resign kar diya. So in July 2013, Gorkha resigned from his post following the center's note to the Telangana's issue and decided to go on indefinite agitation till the demand for separate statehood is met. Now come what triggered the present crisis. In 2014 Lok Sabha election, BJP's manifesto acknowledged aspiration of the various small ethnic groups, promised them to sympathetically consider the demand. So this gave the boost to the Gorkhas. Gorkhas ko laga after the election their demand for the separate statehood like the Gorkha land can be met. On the other hand, Bengalis are very touchy about their language. In fact, on the both sides of the border, Bengalis have given their life for their language. But today, people in Kolkata, they don't know Bengali. So there are some kind of demand that Mamata Banerjee, the current CM of Bengal, has to do something regarding it. So what she did, she decided to make Bengali as a compulsory language or a second language in the schools to learn, which ignited the demand for Gorkhaland once again. Initially, this was a peaceful protest which turned to the violent one after the killing of the 3 civilians and injuries to the many others. Now, present agitation is led by the Bimal Gurung, who lost his popularity after the resignation as a CEO of GTA. So, now he wanted to regain his foothold in the region. Then Mamata Banerjee gave a move. So, he tried to give a counter move by raising the old slogans of the Gorkhaland. But if they have any genuine grievance about the agreement or not being fulfilled, they could raise the issue to the both government of India or to the state government, but they are not doing this. Instead, they are demanding for a separate state, which cannot be possible. Let's see why it cannot be possible. What are the criteria for the formation of a new state? Even we know that two national parties, Congress and BJP, are not supporting this demand because they know that this area, which is very strategically important to the India, because this this area is having a 3 international borders, and this area, Siliguri, and this corridor, which is known as the chicken neck of India, provides link to the northeastern states. So if any kind of turbulence will remain there, it will hamper the linkage with the northeastern states of the India. So let's see what are the criteria for the formation of the state. First of all, preservation and strengthening of unity and security of the nation. सबसे पहले unity की बात करते हैं. India का theme क्या है? Unity in diversity. So if they are demanding for separate state on their language basis, which cannot be possible, it will hamper the unity of India. Secondly, security of the country. It is a border area which is strategically very important for India. So if some kind of turbulence will there, or inko agar ek alag se statehood ka darja de bhi diya jaye na, they will remain more loyal to their land rather than the nation. So it will create further problem to the nation. So first wo criteria ye met fulfill nahi kar rahe. Second, linguistically and the culturally homogeneity. Yes, their language, that is a Nepali, and the cultural homogeneity is different from this region, the rest of the Bengal region. Then finally, financially and economically and administratively, it is not possible. Financially and economically, as it is a border district, factories yahan lag nahi sakti. Theek hai, sirf service sector hai jata hai, develop karne ke liye. Tea plantation already crisis mein hai yahan pe. Tourism and tea plantation hi hai yahan pe, kaam karne ke liye. So financially, it cannot be possible. Then come to the planning and promotion of the welfare of the people in each state as well as of the nation of the whole. Agar baat kare ke welfare of the nation, it will not be in the favor of the welfare of the nation. This region is strategically important to our India. So what is the possible solution for this problem? As government of India was a party to the tripartite agreement, government of India has to call for a meeting to the all political parties and try to find a solution. So first, they have to initiate the talk to them. Second, by creating a state will not solve the problem. So Darjeeling is strategically important to India, which provides a link to the northeastern states. So they have to come to a middle path. ठीक है, middle path पे उनको आना ही पड़ेगा और उनके कुछ जो genuine demands होंगी, that can be met. Then come to the next thing, in the education sector, there can be immense potential for the employment. अगर employment मिलगी ना youth को वहां के, आधी problem तो उसी से solve हो जाएगी. Then increase the pace of the development in the region. Hilly region है, ठीक है, development की pace slow तो होगी ही होगी, लेकिन we have to do some extra work to settle down their grievance. Solution to the racial discrimination. This is little bit a long term process for the solution to the racial discrimination, because for this, behavioral changes needed in the Indian society. So we have to understand they are not Nepalis, they are the Indian citizens. So we should not call them Nepalis or something else. So they are the very much part of the India and they are the Indians. This was all about that issue of our Gorkhaland issue. For more awesome lectures, click subscribe button below or follow our Facebook link, whose link is given below in the description. Thank you. Stay tuned.